name that these signs are some of the 500,000 cities in Palestine.
Get it,
Rick. They were depopulated and destroyed in 1948 at the start of a Nakba, the catastrophe in Palestine, creating millions of refugees and continuing to this day.
Friends and supporters, during the holy month of Ramadan, in the mosque, the Aqsa Mosque in Jerusalem, many hundreds of Palestinians were arrested, detained, and in that act of brutality, they tied their hands together, face first, on the ground, their feet and their arms. So we're going to do this moment here, today, in this city, many, many miles away. We promise not to tie you too tight. Come forward and join this moment, which we'll record now.
True peace is found in Jesus Christ. You know, we come today as brothers and sisters in Christ. God bless you, man.
My brother, we're just going to do a little thing here.
No problem.
Is that alright?
Yeah, how long will that take?
It won't take too long.
Like 5 minutes?
5 minutes?
No problem. Yeah, I'll respect you guys. I'll just wait for you guys to pass. Yeah, no problem.
Good on you, brother.
God bless you, man.
Wondering what's happening here. This scene has actually happened in real life. When worshippers in Al-Aqsa Mosque were taken outside of the mosque during the holy month of Ramadan, zip-tied on the floor, and they were not allowed to do their prayers. So this scene isn't just an imaginary scene. It is a repeat of what actually happened in Palestine.
For 75 years, when you see the persistence of the Palestinian children, you know there is courage. Palestinians have taken something that's intangible and made it tangible. The courage is defined, it's clear, it's precise, it's right there. For when you see a Palestinian, you can visualize courage. When we shake hands with the Palestinian, it is as though we can hold courage. Those of you who are not Palestinian, raise your hands. If you're not a Palestinian, raise your hands. Make sure before you leave today, you hug a Palestinian, for when you hug a Palestinian, you embrace courage. The Palestinians are an inspiration for every oppressed people around the world and the entirety of humanity owes them a debt. I take this opportunity to present a poem. A poem inspired by a young Urdu activist by the name Amir Aziz, who spoke out against the oppression of minorities in India. And through these words you will realize how the Palestinian resistance is at the core of every struggle. Amir says, "It will be remembered, all of it will be remembered, our loved ones lost to your butchery, their memories that leave our hearts in misery. With ink, your lives are written, deep with our blood, the truth too will be written. It will be remembered, all of it will be remembered. You shut down our streets in the light of day and seal our cities in the cold of night. Bearing hammers and guns, you sneak into our homes, break our heads, our limbs, and snatch our little ones. We will pound the evidence of your abuse onto our bones. It will be remembered, all of it will be remembered, the treacherous ways in which you conspired to steal our land, as will be remembered the ways we clenched onto it with these hands. When humanity reflects on a time of death and destruction, your actions will be remembered. When humanity reflects on a time of courage and resilience, our names will be remembered. Yes, indeed, our names will be remembered, that there were these mortal beings whose will could not be broken by iron hammers, sticks and stones, who smiled in the face of bullets, rifles, missiles and drones, those who stood tall through the eye of the storm, the Shireens and the Kadhafis. The Shireens and the Kadhafis will remain alive after the news of their death was known. It will be remembered, all of it will be remembered. The eyes may forget how to blink, the earth forget how to spin, but will be remembered our flight with feather wings, our raspy voice, our resistance. You ask for proof of our identity. You ask for proof of our identity. We will show you the meaning of existence. You write the darkness of the night, we write the beauty of the moonlight. Lock us in prisons, we will ex-freedom into its walls. Murder us, yes, murder us. We will come back as ghosts, try to find. You write jokes inside courtrooms. You write jokes inside courtrooms. We will write justice on the streets outside. It will be remembered. All of it will be remembered. We will speak so loud that even the deaf will hear. Write so clear that even the blind will see. Your writing is like a black notice. Our writing is like the red of roses. You write injustice on these lands. Keep writing injustice on these lands. It will be remembered. All of it will be remembered. So yeah, you write your injustice on these lands. Now watch us. Watch us as we paint intifada rebellion on the skies. For 75 years, my brothers and sisters, Israeli bombs have taken the walls of Palestinian homes. Today, as we continue to march through the streets, let your slogans, your chants, your voices, your storms shake the very foundation of this evil Zionism. As our hearts bleed for Palestine, tell me, my sister, does your heart bleed for Palestine?
Yes.
Tell me, my brother, does your heart bleed for Palestine?
Yes.
Does your heart bleed for Palestine?
Yes.
Then let your throats burn for Palestine. From the river to the sea,
Palestine will be free.
Let the evil Zionist apartheid regime tremble by your anger that is 75 years long. From the river to the sea,
Palestine will be free.
Let the terrorist occupying force be shaken by your rage that is 75 years strong. From the river to the sea,
Palestine will be free.
Never let the oppression around us, the injustices around us, the hypocrisy around us be the reason for our inaction, our silence. Remember, the greatest of struggles.